Hello viewers, you are watching English service of Amhara Television. Today we have a guest for you. My guest is Mr. Yehano Alam. He is a government communicator of Industry and Investment Bureau of the region. We want to discuss about issues related with industry and investment of the region. Stay with us. What does it seem the current status of industry and investment after the reform process of the country?
The reform process brought both challenges and opportunities for our region's investment. For example, if I mention some of the opportunities that brought with the reform program, is that high aspirational motivations on the side of the officials, especially higher officials, are highly motivated to support investment. Again, investors who has a power to invest. The region is rich both in potentials, and even investors, local investors, are also a lot in our region. So these investors are also highly aspiring to develop their regions. Diasporas are also aspiring, even professionals of different associations. For example, the economic associations and so on are highly aspiring to work together with the government to boost investment in the regions. The other opportunities that came with the reform is solving of power problems. Power is a problem in our region still. Amhara region is highly disadvantaged, especially in power distributions, either deliberately or unknowingly. So the region was highly claimed for a long time for the federal government because the region is highly disadvantaged in power. So we apply, we claim for the federal government, but no one was given a quick response. But after the reform, at least the federal government accept our questions. They understand the region is disadvantaged with power. For example, in Debre Brahan, new substation is built already. Woldia, Gonder, Azazo, Debre Tabor, and so on are also upgraded. And Dejan, Bure, Dangla, and Chilga is also promised to be operational in the near few months.
What are good opportunities, especially for local and foreign investors, so as to invest them in the region?
Our region is potentially rich in tourism because UNESCO registered tourist attraction centers like the Sime National Mountain, the Castle of Gonder, the Hyun Church of Lalibela, even the biosphere of Lake Tana and its monastery are also another opportunity areas in tourism. Manufacturing is also another opportunity areas because we are rich in minerals, agricultural products like pulses, crops, even animal resources are also another opportunity area, horticulture, because the climate condition of the region is very good for horticulture, vegetable and so on cultivations. Agro-processing is also common. So to utilize these resources, the government is doing the many things to make the ground fertile or favorable for investors, both for local and regional, foreign investors. For example, with the cooperation of the federal government, we built five industrial parks in the region, like Kombolcha, Debre Brahan, Bure, Bahar Dar, and Ararti. All these developed industrial lands are distributed both for local and foreigners. For example, in Bure, local investors are participating in that areas, but the rest are for reserved for foreigners to get currency. Reorganizing our organization to make or to facilitate our service deliveries and so on are opportunities that we are doing to the business to make the business climate good for investors.
The region is full of resources, Therefore, what activities or what policies and strategies are you following to attract local and foreign investors?
The first thing to attract investor is knowing your resources and make which one to be invest first, because we have competitors from other regions. So after identifying our resources, we are preparing a different modalities to attract investors. Mm-hmm. For example, one is a promotion. We promote investors using electronics medias like radio, television, and other mass medias like Facebook's websites and so on. We also promote by press, by printing materials like brochures, pamphlets, and so on and so on. We also making mass promotions, that means face to face. We are calling investors and discussing with them to reinvest and to make them ambassadors. Okay. To attract another investors.
Therefore, what activities are you performing especially to modernize the industry and investment sector in terms of service provision or either transferring land to local and foreign investors? Is there anything that you perform to make the sector modernize?
Investors are different from other customers. Some investors are maybe better than you. Mm-hmm. So you have to be equipped. You have to be knowledgeable. Mm-hmm. You have to be good in technology use and so on. Mm-hmm. So to make our service delivery mm-hmm. modernized, one, we try to use electronics mm-hmm. To make our service delivery computerized. We study one project with Bahada University mm-hmm. to make our service delivery online. Mm-hmm. So the project is nearly in a finish time. Mm-hmm. So within a few months, we start to online service to get, for example, license. It may be license. So we try to computerize our service delivery. Second, we reorganized our organization. Mm-hmm. Before a year, investment commission is in one area as a commission. Mm-hmm. Industry is in another sector with trade and trade development bureau. Mm-hmm. So after the reform, we reorganized and make them one organization and reach our service up to the Woreda level, our organization up to the Woreda level. Before, investment commission was not extending its organization up to the Woreda level. Mm-hmm. But now we extend our service delivery at Woreda level, so investors can get service from a grassroots level. Third, we open liaison office in Addis Ababa, especially in Addis. There are potential investors who came from abroad mm-hmm. or maybe investors from the region, mm-hmm. but they may live in Addis. Okay. So instead of coming to Bahadar, they can get their our service.
The flow of local and foreign investors after the reform process of the country.
Despite our country is in some conflicts, our region is relatively in peace. So the flow of investment is increasing from time to time. For example, if we take the first quarter, we plan to attract 554 investors, but our performance is more than 600. Mm-hmm. So the investment flow is increasing. Another experience that shows the increasing of investment flow is investment which was operating before now becoming functional. For example, bure oil production, Ararti Ceramic Factory, Gondar Garment and Textile, Dajan Cement Factory, Bure Bio Chemical, and so on are the investors that start to operational after a reform. So the reform program boosts investment flow in our region in general.
What are challenges facing the industry and investment sector currently at the region?
Power is one basic problem yet. Second, foreign currency. Investors want to buy machines, different machines, raw materials, and so on from abroad. So currency is a problem. On the side of the investors, there is also a problem of land abuse. Some investors preparing a proposal to have a land, but after getting the land, they simply fence that area and seeking another investors to transfer with some profits. Okay. That means the rent seekers are collecting a land. So this is one problem again. Misuse of loans and incentives is also another problem. For example, we support them to get a loan from the banks, 30 to 70 ratio. That means, let's assume if they have 100 million project proposals, they are asking to fulfill 30% of that project proposals. The rest 70% will provide by the bank if the project is viable. So after getting that loans, instead of developing their investment, they transfer to that money to another, maybe building buildings or buying a car and so on and so on. So misuse of loans, again misuse of construction materials. We allow to bring construction materials and machines duty free, but after getting the duty free, let's assume it may be construction material. So instead of a building or constructing a shed for their investment, they transfer that metal or cement and something to home constructions. So such and such are problems that we face. Again, we also unable to, nowadays, investment flow is in a good situation. It increases from time to time, but we are unable to provide land for all investors who are asking land. Federal government is designing a strategy to solve these problems. One, the developments of industry parks. When we are developing industrial parks, we can easily attract foreigners who can invest and sell their products to abroad and getting foreign currencies. So that's why the federal government is developing industrial parks in Mekele, in Bahar Dar, Adama, Kombolcha, and so on and so on. Second strategy is developing horticulture. That means flower production. Flower is directly export to get foreign currency, and it is quick to produce a flower. Within a year, one investor can collect money. But when we are looking at another manufacturing activities, it takes 3, 4, 5 years to get the first product. So developing or facilitating and attracting more investors in horticulture is another approach. Another approach is also giving priorities for investors, especially in manufacturing sectors. For those who are participating in manufacturing, banks give priorities. Again, when investors are coming from abroad, we allow to buy with their currencies. There is a system with the bank, which allows for investors to buy raw materials and other machineries with their dollars.
Okay.
But still it is a challenging for our both for our region and for the country.
What activities have you taken to solve these challenges facing the industry and investment sector of the region?
Still, power is a problem not only for our region, but also it is a problem for the country. So more than 12 power projects are there in our country, including the Renaissance Dam.
Mm-hmm.
So facilitating these projects and to produce additional power is one method. As a region, we try to attract investors because we have a potential to produce more than 5,700 megawatt power.
Okay.
From different sources, from water, from geothermal, from wind. For example, if we take wind, the Devre Marcos area alone can produce 200 megawatts.
Okay.
There is a potential of wind. Even solar is also another mechanism. So as a federal government, they try to facilitate to finish the projects who are, which are started earlier. Another, for those who abuse the land,
mm-hmm.
we open a discussion with investors.
Okay.
For example, a week before, we conduct conferences in Devre Brahan.
Mm-hmm.
We were talking with investors. They raised so many questions. We also raised the questions. So we discussed, we together discuss with the problems and we put solutions.
Okay.
So if they have a problem on the side of the government, we try to solve that problems. If they are a problem of investors,
mm-hmm.
we support, we give warning letters,
mm-hmm.
then at least in the other way they start to operate. We collect or snatch that land and transfer to another investors. So we agreed the government should have solved the problems and the investors should have to committed to invest.
Okay.
The same is true in Gondar. There was also a forum in Gondar. So we all together with power supply organizations, loan providers, investment, power and other, all stakeholders were there. So we are putting some solutions for the problems.
Do you believe that these manufacturing companies are creating job opportunity for the people living in the region?
When we are evaluating our region with its potential, still we are low, we are in a back. That's why at the beginning I said the officials, the investors of the region, especially indigenous investors,
mm-hmm.
are highly aspiring and by comparing themselves with the other regions.
Mm-hmm.
They said Amhara is potentially rich.
Mm-hmm.
There is a mineral, there is agricultural products, there is animals. So why it becomes behind Oromia or behind Tigray and so on and so on. So they promised for themselves to invest and reinvest and to attract many investors. But starting a few years ago, investment in our region is, I can say it boosts.
Mm.
It boosts. For example, let me say edible oil production of Balaina Kunde in our region is a huge investment which can create 1,000 up to 2,000 job opportunities. WD oil, edible oil factory in Devre Marcos is also another manufacturing industry which can create job opportunities more than 500.
Mm-hmm.
Bahar Dar Industrial Park now. It's recruiting stage of job seekers.
Mm-hmm.
So when it operates fully, it will create about 6,000 up to 10,000 job opportunities. There is also ceramic and cement factories in Ararti,
mm-hmm.
Which can now produce 500 job opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
kombolcha by itself at a moment it can create more than 2000, but when it starts fully operate it will create more than 10,000 job opportunities. Debre Brahan is also the same. It will create now investors are operating their machines. So within a few months they will start to employ more than 6,000 job seekers. So at a moment our region is in a good and promising stage despite we are in a problematic situations. For example, let me say performance of our first quarter. We plan to attract 554 investors, but we perform greater than 600. So this shows that the despite the region, despite the country is in problematic area, investors are coming in our region. Especially local investors are highly motivated.
Market competitiveness is one of a problem facing local and foreign investors as a region. What can you say about the market competitiveness of local and foreign investors who are manufacturing different kinds of products in the region?
Foreign investors didn't have a problem of market because they have market. The world is very great, very big. There is a market. So since they have networks, foreigners is not any problem of market, but local investors are facing such a problems.
Okay.
Why they face a problem?
Okay.
One, they use old machines.
Okay.
Because since their capacity is very low, they bought old machines. Some are using inputs which are not good quality. So if the inputs are not good, the output also with a problem. The machine, the shape, the design, the mold and so on is also our support, their quality. All this have a problems or their quality of production. Another big problem is the attitude of the people. Including me and you. We are not buying local products. When we are looking Indians and the Chinese, they are highly committed to buy their country products. But the people in our region is not committed to buy and support local investors. To solve these problems, we try to support to produce quality goods. Second, we try to find a market and make an attachment either in local or in abroad. And we also advise them to go to abroad and getting experience sharing. For example, we sent many leaders and experts from the region to collect different types of experience from abroad and to apply to support investors in our region. So as you mentioned, local investors have a problem of a market, but the problem is not a market problem. Rather, it is a quality problem, and identifying where is a resource market.
Okay.
So to solve that problem, the regional government is organizing one team who supports investors to get market for their products.
I think security is the most important thing from all things. If there is no any kind of security, we expect that there is no any kind of industry and investment. There is no development at all.
Yeah.
Therefore, what kinds of activities are you doing, especially with concerned bodies, to make the region as well as investment areas safe enough for local and foreign investors?
Yeah, Amhara region is known by its peace and security for a long time. One challenge which came with reform is security problem. First, with this challenge, very few projects was damaged. So the regional government is committed to support them and give some compensations. Of course, it is not saying compensation, rather it becomes better to say support, because we are not giving full compensation. But about 25% of their damage is compensated. The regional government is giving support. One second, after a long discussion with the local people, the leaders, the officials and stakeholders, we reached to organized investment policy. They as the community policy, the policy is organized to follow securities of investment. For example, we organized in Kombolcha because there is many projects there, Debre Brahan, Bahar Dar. We will also continue in another areas. So the solution for forever is not preparing a guard, rather change the attitude of the people and make a secure. So we were discussing the local people, why you damage investment. If you damage investment, you damage or you lose your job opportunities. You lose your currency. You lose the developments of the region. So many people accept and stand to support investors. On the side of the investors, we advise investors to support and working together with the communities of the local people. So for the long run, we are ready to work together. So now the regional government is highly committed to secure the region, unless and otherwise there is no security, not only investment, all activities will be disturbed. Okay. So the government is highly committed to secure the regional peace.
Okay, let me give chance for you. Anything that you want to say about the industry and investment sector, especially for local and foreign investors to invest in the region? Anything that you want to convey as a message?
Amhara region is a peaceful region, I can say. Now it is secure. It is rich in potential. The government is highly committed. So we prepare a land, especially in Bure Industrial Park, with a full infrastructure development. So both local and foreign investors are invited to come and invest in Bure, especially in agro processing. And for the diasporas, I want to transfer one message again. As a diaspora, they should have to be ambassador of their region. If they can have a chance to invest, it's possible to invest, unless and otherwise, I'm asking them to be ambassador and promoter of their region to come and invest in their region.
Hello viewers, this is the end of our program. Next time we'll bring another very important educative program for you.